We have everything we need, Lord. We will have the security that we need, Lord. We will have King of Kings, that life that we are yearning for, Holy Spirit, Lord. We choose to surrender those wells, Lord. We surrender those wells, Lord, King of Kings, Lord. The wells of talent, Lord. by your love. I want to desire what you desire. I want to hear from you. I want you to be my source. I don't want any broken well to be my source. I don't want maybe broken wells of social media to be my source. I want to desire you to the point that actually nothing can define me but you. No tangible thing can define me but you. Lord, we pray that you may captivate our hearts, Lord. Father, we pray, Lord, King of Kings, Lord, that you may captivate our hearts, Lord, that we may desire more of you. Not things, Lord. Let us not love the work we do much than we love you. Let us not love much serving than we actually love you. Let us not love much speaking than actually we do it in your life, Lord. We pray that you may captivate our hearts, Lord. Captivate our hearts, Holy Spirit, Lord. I pray, Holy Spirit, Lord, that you captivate each and every person's heart here. Father, there are many things that are distracting us, Lord. Many things are seeking for that desire which you are asking from us, Lord. They want to take it away from you, Lord. But help us, Lord. Captivate us, Lord. Captivate us, Lord. Lord, where there are those things that are coming, Lord, for our attention, Lord. We pray that you may captivate us, Lord. We pray that you may captivate us, King of Kings, Lord. Holy Spirit, captivate us, and King of Kings, Lord. Not to be God distracted, Lord. We pray that we may come to a place, Lord, knowing that you are our well, Lord, that never runs dry, Lord, knowing that our jobs, Lord, our family, trust, Lord, King of Kings, Lord, all that looks promising, Lord, those are actually broken wells, Lord. They won't satisfy us, Lord, but when we have you, Lord, we'll see satisfaction in those things, Lord. Because we have you, Lord, we'll see satisfaction in our jobs, Lord. Because we have you, Lord, we will experience that joy, Lord. Captivate our hearts, Lord. Captivate, church, pray that God may captivate your heart. Captivate your heart. Captivate. The devil is fighting for that desire that you may gear it to wrong direction. There's a time where Jesus prayed for Peter. He told that Peter, I've prayed for you. I've prayed for you. I believe actually the prayer can do something much. We see even Peter, due to that prayer that Jesus prayed, Peter's desire for Jesus grew more and more. Yes, pray right now. That desire can grow. The desire for prayer can grow. Yes, God can do it. Ask God to put their ways of actually how he can steal your heart. Pray for those opportunities. Pray for those opportunities. That God, give me opportunities where you can captivate my heart. The first opportunity is right here as you are praying. Yes, do not allow anything to distract you. Do not allow anything to distract you. God has given you that opportunity right now. God, captivate our hearts. Captivate our hearts, Holy Spirit, Lord. Captivate our hearts, Lord. Captivate our hearts, Lord. Captivate our hearts, Lord. Lord, give us an exchange, Lord. Where our desire has been so much in pornography, Lord. If our desire has been so much into drugs, Lord. That is empty, Lord. Even when we take a lot of drugs, Lord. Even when we see a lot of pornography, Lord. Those are all broken wells, Lord. They just bring a moment relief, Lord. We pray that we may be lured by you, King of Kings, Lord. We pray that we may draw satisfaction from you. Become our satisfaction, Lord. We yearn that you may satisfy us, Lord. Lord, we won't go to the wells, Lord, that are broken, Lord. We choose to go away from broken wells. We'll pick our desire from you, Holy Spirit. Broken wells won't satisfy us, Lord. They won't satisfy us, Lord. Yes, Lord. Pray to your God. Because your God knows what actually distracts you. Your God knows where actually you're weak, Lord. Your God knows what takes his desire from you. He knows what distracts you. He knows the things that are competing for his desire. So pray to God that, God, help me. Help me that my desire may be geared to you. Not things, not petty things. Not screens, Lord. Not my phone. Lord, you know what takes my desire away from you. I pray that you may show me those things, Lord. I pray you may take away those things, Lord. Yes, pray to your God right now. He knows. We're going to pray for one thing as we are finishing. But keep praying. Still in the book of Hosea, chapter 2, verse 14. Therefore, this is the Lord speaking for a prophet. Therefore, behold, I will allure her and bring Namasi. I will allure her and bring her into the wilderness and speak tenderly to her. And there I'll give her vineyards and make the valley of Acha the door of hope. And there she shall answer in the days of her youth. As at a time when she came out of the land of Egypt. We've been praying to God to give us that desire. To give us back that passion that was lost. When the children of Israel had wandered away from the Lord, the prophet, God spoke through the prophet that I'll take them into a wilderness and there I'll show love to them. I'll try to captivate their hearts in the wilderness. I'm going to ask you to make a dangerous prayer right now that God, if it needs you to take me into a wilderness. If that's what it will take for you to captivate my heart, I pray that you may take me into that wilderness. Because what he promises in the end here in the word, it is good, it is profitable.
Chirunji chisanyusa.
He says, and here I'll give her vineyards and make the valley of Achor a door of hope. I want you to pray that dangerous prayer. Yes, as
you're
finishing. Lord, we pray that you may help us, Lord. As you want to captivate our hearts, Lord, we pray you may help us walk through the valley that you want us to walk through. If it is going to take that for you to captivate our hearts, Lord, Father, we take the assignment, Lord, because we know in the end it is going to profit, Lord. In the end it is going to profit, Holy Spirit, Lord. Father, come and move, Lord. Walk us through the valley, Lord. Father, come and speak tenderly, Lord, to those that have no hope, King of Kings, Lord. To those that don't think that desire can be there anymore, Lord. Father, come and speak tenderly wherever they are, King of Kings. Even in that valley, in that wilderness where they are right now. Father, come and captivate their hearts, Lord. Father, we choose to take that, Lord, because we know we'll draw satisfaction in the end, Lord. Thank you, Lord, because you are captivating our hearts today. Amen, amen.
Amen.
And the whole church says,
amen,
amen, amen. Let us welcome the worship team to take us.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to worship and prayer evening today. Just find someone near you and tell them, welcome to the house of God. Tell them, come on, get ready. We're going to worship the Lord together. We're going to lift our praise to Him together. We're going to call upon His name together. Amen. Amen. I want to welcome all those that are watching online. Just plug in your home where you are. Encourage yourself in the Lord. And let's worship the Lord together this evening. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Chidala wabula tendereza yeba sibwe hallelujah sirina chidala wabula tendereza nengenda nga tendereza sirina chidala wabula tendereza yeba sibwe hallelujah sirina chidala wabula tendereza nengenda nga tendereza.
Bible says in Luke chapter 9 from verse 12.
Bible igamba weti muluka mwenda olunyiriro kuna.
From verse 12.
Okuba kulunyiriro. Okuba kulunyiriro kumine mbili.
When the day began to wear away, the 12 came and said to him, send the multitude away that they may go into the surrounding towns. And lodge and get provisions, for we are in a deserted place here. But he said to them, you give them something to eat. And they said, we have no more than 5 loaves and 2 fish. Unless we go and buy food for all these people. Verse 14 says, for there are about 5,000 men. Then he said to his disciples, make them sit down in groups of
50.
And they did so and made them all sit down. Then he took the 5 loaves and the 2 fish, and looking up to heaven, he blessed and broke them and gave them to the disciples to set before the
multitude.
So they all ate and were filled, and drove baskets of the leftover fragments were taken up by them. I was asked to help to lead us in a prayer for our economy, and we shall be praying. And when I ask the Lord, what am I going to share with your people? He brought me to this portion of scripture. And what stood out for me is how the disciples said, we should send these people away. We are in a deserted place. There is nothing here. But the Lord says, no. They are remaining here. Let them sit down. Let them sit down. You know, we want to wake up in the morning and then find that things have gone back to what we are used to. We want to wake up and then we see the economy is back to what we are used to being. But what if God just wants to take you through? Maybe we don't have to look for greener pastures. And all we have to do is to show our trust in God. To sit down where the Lord is. And trust that the little we have, He can make it enough for us. Maybe we need to hear the words of Jeremiah the prophet, when he says in chapter 29 that build houses and dwell in them. Plant gardens and eat the fruit of them. Plant gardens and eat the fruit of those gardens. I know the conditions are unfavorable, but the first sermon we had of the Creating Wealth series, they were teaching us about the faith commitment. Have faith in God. The Bible says Isaac planted in that land, he sowed in that land. The land was a desert, but the same year he reaped 100-fold. Maybe we need to do, as Jeremiah was saying, that seek the peace of the city. And pray to the Lord for it. For in its peace, you shall have peace also. And the peace, when you pray for the peace of the country, then we shall also have peace. You know, it is not about how much you have or how much you don't have. It is about what God can do with what you trust Him with. How ready are we to trust God and say, the little I have, Lord, I give it to you? How ready are we to say, Lord, you know I don't have much, but even the little I have, I'm giving it to you, Lord. And I want us now in this moment to lift up our faith in a prayer of surrender. Let us surrender to God. Tell Him where you are, whatever job you're doing, whatever you think about the economy. Tell Him, Lord, I want to trust you in this moment. I want to trust you with the economy. Lord, it may not go away tomorrow. It may not go away at the end of the month. The situation may not change at the start of the new month. But Lord, I want to trust you with the little I have. Lord, I want to trust that whatever flour is left in my cistern, whatever oil is left in my cruiser, Lord, I will trust you with it, oh my God. I want to give it to you, Holy Master. Because when I give you my two fish, oh Lord, when I give you my five loaves of bread, oh Lord, you will multiply them, oh Father. When I trust you even with my little money, when I trust you with my job, oh Lord, I know that you'll provide for me out of it, and I'll lack nothing. Lord, lift our hearts to have trust in you, Lord. Your word has said, blessed is the man whose trust is in the Lord. Blessed is the man whose hope the Lord is. Lord, we want to be as them that trust you, O glorious Lord. Not our finance ministers, Lord. Not our export policy or import policy. We do not trust the forex rates, O Lord. But we want to trust you, glorious Lord, with all that we have and all that we have. The Bible says, in the book of 2 Kings, and chapter 6, verse 25. What the Bible says. And there was a great famine in Samaria. And indeed they besieged it until a donkey's head was sold for 80 shekels of silver. And 1/4 of a cup of dove droppings for 5 shekels of silver. The situation was that bad. But in the next chapter, just know that things were so expensive. Things were... what we may say today, things were impossible. In the next chapter, chapter 7, the Bible tells us in verse 1. Then Elisha said, hear the word of the Lord. Hear the word of the Lord. Thus says the Lord, tomorrow about this time, a share of fine flour shall be sold for a shekel, and 2 shares of barley for a shekel at the gate of Samaria. Elisha was a prophet. I bless God that He has said He has given some to be prophets. I want to invite you to get onto your feet. I want us to lift our faith once again. Peter says, Lord, increase our faith. Peter says to Jesus, increase our faith. And I want us now to also lift our faith and make some prophecies in this place. Make some prophecies about your life, about your work, about your family, about the economy. It doesn't matter. Just prophesy, prophesy. I know the Spirit of the Lord is present in this place. I know the power of God is at work. And when we speak,
the spiritual sets into motion. When we speak, God goes to work. When we speak, the Spirit of God is at work for us. Prophesy and speak things into life. Prophesy and speak faith into life. Prophesy and tell God what you want to see. Prophesy and tell God my work. Prophesy and tell God my salary. Prophesy and tell God our economy. We want peace, O Lord. We want a development, O Lord. We want a return, O Holy Master. We want to go back, O Lord. We want to do that. We're trusting in you. Come on. Come on. Prophesy something. Say something. Lift your faith.
Oh, hallelujah, Lord.
Amen. And we bless you, Lord, because you're doing it. The Bible says that this is our confidence, that when we pray according to His will, He hears us. Lord, we believe that you have heard us, Lord. We shall bless your name. Amen, amen, amen.
Dead.
Let's lift our hands to the Lord. And let's clap unto him. He is worthy of the glory. Oh, thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
You may be seated. We are still in the mood of worship.
Tuchali mu kisere ky'okusinza.
You know, sometimes we come to church and we feel it's just going to be the same. But today, when I was coming to church, I really asked the Lord to give me a confirmation about the word that I'm about to share.
And he has
already done it. You see, as we go along. And the brother was sharing about the day that Jesus fed the 5,000. And they didn't have enough. And they actually had gone around counting. And in those days they counted only men. The children and the women were not counted. But as if the miracle wasn't enough, somebody said,
100 men were counted.
But God brought the miracle through a child. And today, we are in the midst of miracles. And I pray that your spirit will be lifted up to expect God to meet you. And the other thing that the Lord told me will happen tonight, that there are going to be a lot of prophecies from you. I almost went to the worship team and said, you know, if the Lord gives you a word, please come and do it. But I didn't. But there it is. So yes, tonight, the Spirit of the Lord is going to come upon every one of us who is here. And as the scripture said, you'll be turned into another man. Hallelujah. Today I'm going to talk about what is God's strategy to take us through the seasons that are dark. And I know that all of us are going through this very dark season. The economy is failing. But maybe for you, it's not the economy, but something else. And you feel that you're going through a dark season. And whereas everyone is talking about the economy and how jobs are failing and money is failing, you feel you can't even talk about what you're going through. But let me tell you today, God has a solution even for that which you have not spoken. And I know we've been going through this season of creating wealth as a church. And we have already realized that there are some things that God can do, that only God can do. But there are other things that you have to do. And tonight, I'm so happy to share with you what God can do and what you're supposed to
do.
I'm going to share some few verses from Psalms 23. And expect to be praying in between my sermons. We're going to stop and pray for that particular area. We won't go through all the verses. I'll just share a few of them with you. And the Bible says in Psalms 23, He restores my soul. Now you know he was talking about him being a sheep and God was a shepherd. So does the sheep have a moment where its soul needs to be restored? Does a sheep
So
does the sheep has a soul?
But David was using this illustration to communicate very great
thing.
There is something that happens to sheep. When they grow fat, and they have a lot of fleece. And they begin to walk around heavy. And they want to rest because they are feeling heavy. So sometimes they fall into a hole. And they fall backwards. I know you'll be able to see that. They actually call that a cursed sheep. A sheep that was too heavy, and as it walked down, it... And once it falls, because it is very heavy, it just rolls around in the mud and it can't get up. And it needs the shepherd. It needs the shepherd. It needs the shepherd to come and lift it up. That is why David says, why are you cast down, O my soul? Hope in God, because I shall yet praise Him. And there's some of us here today, and your soul is downcast. You have fallen on your back, and you're trying to roll in the ground and to get yourself up. But it's not possible. And you know, when your soul is down, nothing else will work. Am I talking to the right people tonight? But today, the shepherd is looking for you. He's coming right where you are. Maybe you have not even told anybody. I was telling Pastor Richard, especially for the men, when something hits you, it's not easy for you to share it with someone. Because men are hunters, they are known to be providers. And then you die on the inside. But today, if you are here, the shepherd is coming and finding you lying on your back and trying to get up. Stop trying. Because the shepherd is coming right where you are.
Kama mulungi.
David, in Psalms 119,
Muzaburi,
Chikumi kumina muenda. Verse 176. 176. The psalmist says, you know, when you go through a hard time, you say, I'm going to seek the Lord. You go for overnight. But something can hit you so bad, you can't even do that. So in this verse, in Psalms 119:176, the psalmist says, Lord, seek your servant.
Nonya.
Today, you may not even be able to seek the Lord. But he's saying, I'm coming right
I want
us to lift our hands right
now
and say to the Lord, Shepherd,
come,
find me.
Find me.
You hear me crying.
I cannot
help myself.
I have
fallen over.
Come
and lift me. Restore my emotions. God is healing emotions right now.
There are
some of you who have emotions that have just gone out of control. You're falling apart. But God is right here today by His Holy Spirit to come and heal you and restore your soul. What else does the psalmist say?
Omuwandiisi wa Zaburi kyekirala
ky'agamba. He leads me.
Ankulembera.
In the paths of righteousness.
Mu kkubo ery'obutuukirivu.
For his name.
Ku lw'erinnya lye lyokka.
The paths that are right. The paths that are right.
Ekkubo ettuufu oba amakubo amatuufu.
They are just and normal.
Ga bulijjo era ga mazima. Matuufu.
And some of us don't even know when you last felt normal. You may not put up your hand, but I want you to nod. If that is happening to you. And one thing about the sheep. The sheep are so into habits.
Endiga. What will we be ramu muze?
Jibera endiga tezimanyi kuchusa. That's how it's going
so
to
it's
be.
It's very constant.
They're so habit forming. They can even graze in an area and eat even the stones. Because they don't know how to move on. You might be here today. You've just been going round and round and round. You're just grazing on that very same thing. You know it's not fulfilling, but you can't get. What does a shepherd do? He leads them. So today what you have to do. Move with the Lord. Long for Him.
We've been singing.
Hearts are yearning for you.
We
are so tired of being in the same circle. Like we are a car that is stuck in mud.
And
we keep on. Our wheels are squeaking.
And we
just don't know how to do it. But here is the shepherd leading you on and maybe coming alongside you and pushing you out of that cycle that you are in. Can we lift our hands today? Tell the Lord where you are stuck. Lord, I don't know how to change. I don't know how to do new things. I'm stuck in a habit. I don't want it, but I just don't know how to get out of it. Oh God. Oh Shepherd. Come and get me out of here. Thank you, Lord. And then it says, and though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will not fear. Why is David speaking like this and
Dawoodi,
yet he's giving us an image of sheep?
It's
because if you want to go up, If you want to go up, you've got to go. He'll lead the sheep up to the mountain. But it had to walk through the valley. And I want you to know, that valley is not a station. It's not a place to be. But as the scripture says, even though I walk through, he already mentioned it. God is walking you through. But why did the shepherd put his sheep where there were valleys? Why not always on the mountain? Because in that valley, there was water. The water is in the valley. The green pasture is in the valley. You know what else is in the valley? As the sheep walks through with the shepherd, the predators, the animals that would eat the sheep, would actually stay there. They knew that the sheep are going to come. But the shepherd, he has promised, I cannot not take you through this place where there is green pastures, where there is water, where there is a springs of water. I'm going to deal with a predator. And so let me tell you today, the season you're going through, don't wait for the mountain, because there are treasures in the valley. There are treasures in the valley. The Bible actually tells us that I'm going to give you the treasures of darkness. God is saying to you today, don't waste this valley season. Don't wait for another good day. Don't wait for everything to be okay. But because he's a very good shepherd, he knows the right way you are going through. There are treasures. And so this night, tell God the situation you are going through. And God wants to give you treasures. So when you go over, you have reaped out of the valley season. Let us lift our hands right now and ask the Lord. Yes, Lord. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. And Lord, we've been saying to you, Lord, we've been saying to you tonight, Hosanna. Hosanna.
Hosanna.
Because when we see you, you give us strength to go through the day. Cause us, Lord, not to just go through, but also reap from the
land.
Thank you, Lord. Let's thank the Lord. You anoint my head with oil.
Ofuka mafuta ku mutwe gwange.
Wow, my cup runs over.
Tie chikompe kyange chiboga.
You know the sheep,
Endiga,
had a problem.
Zabanga nechizibu.
They would get some flies that would come and dwell and land on their noses.
Enswera zine zajjanga nezitula ku mitwe ba ku nyindo.
Like you have the dogs,
we call it kawawa.
They have these little flies that come. And those flies would lay eggs in the nose. And the larvae would grow up and go into the skull and go into the brain.
How would you know that whether
those things have actually gone into the brain of the sheep?
The sheep would bang
their heads on anything.
They would actually
bang themselves so hard that sometimes they would kill themselves.
Because
the fly and the larva have actually gone into the brain.
Maybe
you are not a sheep. But sometimes you go through things that you just kind of burn yourself. Things that actually make you harm yourself. Some actually go with suicidal thoughts because the pain is so much. And how does a shepherd prevent this? Applies oil on the head.
Ateka kama futa kumotwe gwendiga. Gego getulabye gebayu wako.
Hallelujah.
Banange chochikuru nyo.
Oh God.
Ukama ole morunji.
Receive the anointing of the Lord.
Tufuna mafuta ga mukama ago.
The anointing is not to preach or sing.
Amafuta agogerwako siku yimirira kwasanguza matendo
na kubulira. The anointing of God protects your mind.
Amafuta ga katonda kuma birowozo byonga biri
wamu. Some of here who have got thoughts that will never even happen, but they are troubling you.
Ebirowozo ebiwankubadde bichankala na nebi
siba. And today God comes. And he applies the oil of the Holy Spirit to give you renewed thinking, to change your thinking tonight, to give you a sound mind. The oil drives away the flies. The oil of the Holy Spirit. Receive the oil of the Holy Spirit. Jesus, we lift our hands to you today. Let your Holy Spirit come. Come, Lord. Drive away the flies. Wow.
Wow.
He anoints his head. My cup runs over. And all this feast he is doing, he sets a table
before
my enemies. In the ancient days, when you are a visitor, when you come in, they would anoint your head with oil, and then they would give you a cup and put wine in the cup until it was overflowing. That means that you are a guest. Let me tell you, David is saying, we are seated with God, but not inside the house. Not somewhere where we are hiding. But he sets the table right in front of the enemy. Right where the enemy is. And he's saying to you, don't worry about them. I'm going to take care of that enemy right now. So be at peace. Have peace. Have peace. Because the great shepherd is anointing your head. Oh, hallelujah, Lord. Let's just pray for a sound mind. We think thoughts that take away our time, take away our creativity. And these things are not real. But the Holy Spirit wants to come today. I want you to pray for your mind. I want you to touch your mind. That God will give you the thoughts of God, the thoughts of heaven. Oh God, come here today, Lord. Oh, exchange the thoughts of God. Put in your thoughts today. We thank you, Lord. Let there be peace. Let's not even think of things that will never happen. Oh God, visit our minds tonight. That is what God promises to do. He anoints your head with oil. He leads you through the valley. And as you go, away with something that was in that channel. So the Lord is telling you, you are not going to go through the valley without taking
You're
anything.
You're going to go through the valley. And carry the treasures. The treasures of the valley. The treasures of the valley.
Yes,
the treasures of the valley belong to you today. Hallelujah. Let's thank the Lord. Hallelujah. But now there is our part. Let's read. Before I tell you what we are supposed to do, let's read Zechariah chapter 1. And verse 18. Yes. Then I looked up, and there before me were four horns. I asked the angel who was speaking to me, what are these? And he answered me, Pastor Lubega will read in Luganda. Zechariah chapter 1, verse 18.
Okay. Katsomoru nyirole kumi, no munana, Zechariah M. Nenyimusa masogange, nent agomachi, nanzira muntigano, ge mayembe, agasasanya muyuda, ne Israeli, ne Yerusalemi. Mukama, nanjole sa, abawe sivana, nenjo geranti, Ababa sajja nti abo bajja kukola ki nayogera nti gano ge mayembe agasasanya Yuda omuntu n'okuyimusa n'atayimusa mutwegwe naye bano bazze okugasagula okusuula amayembe g'amawanga agayimusibwanga ejjembe lyabwe ku nsi ya Yuda okugisasanya.
Here is not talking about the mayembe that
temulowoza gali gali,
but he's actually talking about powers.
Naye ayogera ku manyi ne ku buyinza.
He's talking about a force.
Ayogera ku nsibuke ya manyi.
He sees a vision and he sees horns attacking Judah. And in fact he says that these horns affected Judah. Judah means praise.
Yuda chitegeza tendo ba matendo.
So these horns have come against the people who praise God.
Galumbagane jiria mukame yariri mwa matendo.
So much that they could not even lift up their heads.
Ngatebacha samarabozi gabe kutenda matendo ga mukama.
They couldn't lift up their heads.
They could not
lift up their heads.
Kusitula mitwe kutenda.
How many of you ever gone through such a situation? Bamekanga waliotu seko mu season yoba mu bilobo ebityo. Maybe, you know when you put your head down, it talks about shame. It talks about frustration. It talks about hopelessness. It talks about no vision. Because your head is down. And the Lord says, these forces, this power of the enemy has caused everyone to have their heads go down. And as the prophet was watching, they are carpenters.
Babazi.
You think about these forces. The force is so mighty that there is no one in Judah who can lift up their head. But God sends an unusual instrument. He doesn't send an army. He doesn't send people.
people who are very strong. In fact, they seem like they have no tools. They seem to have no tools.
Carpenters?
Against this very great force? Do you know him too? What is his name? What's his name? Send the spirit of the carpenter upon you. And even when it seems like there is no strength in you, the power of the spirit of the carpenter, the power of the spirit of Jesus is very, very able to conquer any power. And so right then, the heads that are bowed down. Oh, he lifts them up. He lifts up. The psalmist said, but you, O Lord, you are my glory and the lifter of my head. And if you are here tonight and if for any reason you feel your head is bowed down, let the spirit of the carpenter come upon you.
Yay!
And then you can lift your head up. You can see beyond. You can see in the future. You can have creative ideas.
Mukama Murungi. Mukama Murungi.
Lift your heads to the Lord.
Emetwe ya fetu jimuse. Tuleme jikoteka. We wow. Mukama osu. Indeed, Lord.
And the lifter of my head.
We wow.
Lift your hand. Let the shame go. Let the shame go. Let the bowing down go. Let it go.
Kabigende. We wow.
Oh, hallelujah, Jesus. The other thing about these men. Carpenters use their hands. And what God is saying to you today, His strategy to go through this season of darkness is that He's going to bless your hands. He is going to bless your hands. Men who are skilled at your work,